All right, David Harry here. Now, I recently did the maddest vlogging example with the Samsung Galaxy Tab S7. Now, unfortunately, when I did that one, the weather turned dreadful as I was doing it. So, although I think it was a good video to show you some extreme weather conditions for vlogging with an S7, if that's what you were wanting to do, what I did the other day was went out when it was nice and sunny and then used the S7 on top of a tripod to do some straight pieces to camera, like vloggy stuff or kind of presentation type stuff. So what it is, I'm going to now play you some of that stuff here. And also there'll be another video, which there'll be a link to here, doing the exact same thing with an iPad Pro 2020. Now, don't forget as well, as this video plays through, if it entertains you in any way or anything like that, please consider giving it a thumbs up. Also, maybe consider subscribing to my channel and all that funky other stuff. Anyways, on with the video. Okay, so for the first test then, I am on the front camera of the S7. I'll just call it the S7 or Tab or something from here on in. And hopefully, Mr. GoPro over here is also recording as well. So the conditions here for light are very strong light. It's clear blue sky thereabouts everywhere, which we can probably see in the background. So this is going to give us our best chance for this type of camera system to record its best picture. So what I'm going to do is just walk off a little bit as I'm talking. Now, the thing is, I'm not entirely sure what the front camera does and doesn't do as such, so we'll get a good idea of that at the moment. Don't forget, all fully automatic, basic Samsung camera app here. So what I'm going to assume with the front camera, it probably is just fixed focus and stuff, but what we're going to be relying on here is for the camera to be doing a decent job with exposure, especially for the main subject, which will be me. Now what I'm going to do is get a little bit closer into it. So there's a bit closer, it's probably just over, say, a foot away, something like that. Closer again. Now, I don't think we're going to see any kind of bokeh effect or anything, because I just don't think that that's going to happen with this, because I don't think it's going to be doing any focusing. I could be wrong, however. Anyway, right up close to it there, I'll have a little peep inside there. Is there a little person in there with the camera filming me? I don't know. Anyways, that should do it then for that one. What I'm gonna do now is flip over onto the rear camera and let's check that out. Okay, so just over now onto the rear camera, and I'm literally just over a full arm's length away here. Now don't forget, because obviously we're locked off here and you can afford yourself a little bit of like movement within the frame, you can frame yourself exactly as you want it with stuff like this. And as the GoPro will show us there, it'll just show us the distance here. If however you wanted to get further away, that's fine. Then obviously with something like the microphone system that I've got on here, that's definitely going to give us a lot more kind of flexibility with what we're doing here. So what I'll do, I'll just step off a little bit further here. Now again, what I'm doing here is just testing for absolute picture quality in really good light, which is going to affect hopefully the exposure, so we can get a gauge of that properly. Then obviously with the rear camera, it does focus, so we'll get an idea of what focusing does. So what I'm going to do now is just get out the frame a second, and then we'll see what it's doing at the back there and what it decides to snap focus to. Because obviously with this being in fully auto at the moment and I'm not touching to focus on the rear screen or anything, or on the screen, it's just not going to kind of like have any kind of pointers as to what to do. It will make its own mind up. So let's see what it does once I'm in the frame walking around and what have you. Chances are I'm probably just a little bit too far at the moment in order for it to pick me out, and also whether or not it's going to have difficulties picking me out against what the background is as well. So what I'm going to do is get back here into the position that I started off in. So I would say this would be kind of like a presentation vlogging position. Now what I'm going to do is get closer and I'll try and kind of move a little bit into the frame so we can see the background a bit easier and see what's going on. So again, that's just over a foot away, something like that. Don't know my position in the frame, but we're not testing for like framing here right now. We're testing to see what it's doing with focus for me and exposure compared to the background. Now I'll get to this side of it. Let's just see what's going on there. Now we'll get a bit closer again. That's probably 5-6 inches, something like that. Now closer again, I'm thinking it might still be focusing here. But if I get even closer and closer, like a few inches and then down really close, my nose is now touching the back of the pad. Hello, anyone in there? Right, so that'll give us an idea of what it was doing there as far as background, kind of like bokeh, you know, if that's what you want and all that stuff. Now what I'm going to do is just quickly flip the camera around world, and I'll film straight into the sun behind me. Let's just get an idea of what that's like. Okay, so on the front camera now, with the sun directly behind me, sun's kind of just up that way there. Now, I think the really cool thing here is that despite this being a real terrible position as far as the sun is concerned, and obviously I am in complete shade here, what's happening here, the camera is doing its level best to try and gain up for my face because it knows this is what we're trying to record. So of course the back will blow out and various other parts of like the frame will kind of go really hot and stuff. But for the best part, it is trying its best to get me. I'm just looking at the screen right now. I'm actually very surprised at what it's doing here. I would say that this is absolutely useful for certain things that you might want to do with this camera outdoors and stuff. I'm actually quite surprised it's doing this. Now what I'm going to do is just step out the frame. Let's get an idea of what it will try and expose to now. Now what I'm going to do is just come into the frame as quickly as I can and see if I can try and catch it on me. So jump in the frame there quick and see what it does. There's people on the other side here, I think, to one side looking at me like I'm a complete mad person. Anyway, onto the rear camera. So this is now the rear camera. Once again, the sun is literally just over my shoulder up high there. And so the sun is going straight into the lens. Let's see what it's doing. Is it exposing me or anything? You know, can we actually get a decent picture doing this? I would obviously never recommend shooting straight into the sun. It's just that I'm out doing the tests. I might as well try this. Once again, I'll just step out the frame. Let's just see what it does. And then I'll kind of come in wide from the side of the frame here as well. Now, again, I'm not going to kind of like labour the point here too much because with it being pointed round the other way, that's generally going to be your best position for stuff like this. So I'm not going to go mad with this take here. Okay, so that should give us a really good idea of what the rear camera was doing with the sun coming straight into it and whether it's exposing and focusing on me and stuff like that. Anyway, I'm going to shoot off indoors, have a quick look at the footage and then do a bit of an end summary. Okay, so to a bit of an end summary here. Now, I'm not going to go dissecting all kinds of stuff here because we have to kind of get this like into perspective. And that is, we're just looking at cameras which just are very conveniently put on a tablet. So if you've got a tablet like this, either the 7 or the 7 Plus, because they're both exactly the same cameras on them, this is just to give you an idea. Well, this and other videos that I'm doing to do with vlogging with them and also camera quality and stuff, these videos are just to give you an idea of like what you may think you could get away with something like this. Because don't forget, if you've got the option to use a full-on camera, even something like a GoPro, you would use that for vlogging, not one of these types of devices. Although that said, you know, in certain instances you do get great pictures out of them. So let me know in the comment section to this video what you think of the picture quality and if indeed you would find there to be some kind of use with the cameras off these things. Also as well, as I said from the outset of this video, there will be a very similar video done with the iPad Pro, so check me descriptions for links, and also at the end of this video will take you to that video and let me know what you think about that as well. At some point I will do a comparison side by side between the two of them. Also as well, if you've liked the video, then please give us a thumbs up. Also consider subscribing to my channel, all that funky stuff, and I will have an ever-growing playlist with Galaxy S7 stuff in it, which will always be linked to from the descriptions within the videos. And also as well, all the stuff that I use on the S7, all the bits that I buy, again, Amazon links for that stuff in the descriptions below. So the last thing that remains for me to say right now is, I'm David Harry. Thank you very much for watching this video. Take care and goodbye now.